Greetings.
How are you?
I'm listening.
Great to meet you.
Ah, I've been expecting you.
For the good.
You come get the voodoo.
Hey there.
And you are...
Light be with you.
Great to meet
you. You come to consult the spirits?
Welcome to Orgrimmar. Have you come to serve the Horde?
Sail here, me buy, and trade. What?
Hello and welcome to Control Alt WoW, the podcast for those of us who love World of Warcraft and love making many alts. Today is Saturday, January 9th, 2021, and this is episode 692 entitled A Day Early and a Skill Point Short. I'm Aprilian, your host, and with me are my two awesome co-hosts. How are you today, Constructs?
I'm feeling fantastic. I got up early on the right foot today and kept going, and I got a roast in the oven. Things Ooh. Are going well. Ooh. Being adventurous, I cut my own veggies today. I didn't get my wife to do it, so that's pretty good.
Nice. I love cooking. It makes me feel productive.
Nice.
Yes. And Granegas, how are you today? Do you have a roast in the oven?
No, I haven't. I've had some steak.
Oh, nice! How do you like your steak?
Well done. Oh. I'm not a bloody type of guy.
I like to know that the steak won't move.
Yeah, basically.
I mean, there's this whole, especially certain people like Gordon Ramsay and stuff, that it has to be rare, or you're insulting the steak if you cook it too much. But I'm sorry, I like mine knowing that it's not going to move.
Yeah, basically, if you need a club as the third utensil next to your knife and your fork.
Right.
Nothing wrong with the stuff you will eat.
Right, so, yeah. Exactly, yeah.
Again, as I said, I had steak and some bacon on the side.
Nice. So,
yeah, I mean, always, it's like bacon is...
Well, you know, there are so many times when I've been tempted to be, and I'm apologizing to any of our vegetarian listeners, but I want to be a vegetarian, but bacon, yeah.
Can't. Exactly.
Yes.
I mean, if I could, if you had to boil it down for me, I could pick one type of meat.
Right.
That I couldn't, if I had to pick one, it would be bacon.
Yeah.
So there's nothing, and everything is better with bacon. So
yes, just like the quest says.
Yeah.
All right. So speaking of quest, what do we have this week? We've still got Dark Moon Fair for the next few hours until midnight.
Yeah, for the next 4.5 hours.
Yeah.
Something like that. Yeah. And then we have...
It's supposed to be Arena Skirmish if you follow the weird guy in the new ghostly people. And who give you
the brokers?
Quest. Yeah, the brokers. He gives you a quest for mm-hmm. yeah. Arena Skirmish. I don't think I'm going to do it. You get like 50 conquests and something. It's like,
mm-hmm.
That's a lot of pain for not a lot of reward, I find.
Yeah. Yeah, and then we have the PvP brawls. It's ending on Tuesday. That's still the Arathi Basin or Arathi Blizzard that takes place in the Arathi Basin. And then the new stuff we're going to get on Tuesday or Wednesday or Thursday, depending upon your location on this world of ours.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be the World Quest bonus event, the first one in Shadowlands. And then we have the mysterious Torghast Beast of Progium. Don't know if I'm butchering the name. I probably am. I have no idea what that is. I have no clue what it is. If, again, as I said last week, it might be that it's got to do with the twisted corridors that are going to open, but they have already opened them. So they moved the unlock cycle up a week, in that they normally the quest chain is on a 1 week. It goes on a 1 week lockout, where every week you get the new chapter, so to speak, much as with the story for Shadowlands and the Renown. But apparently, with this week, they removed the barrier, so you could just finish the last quests in the chain and unlock the twisted corridors, which are I've run through the place, some of it. Mm-hmm. It's the normal Torghast towers, wings are six floor climb, and then you have the final boss with the twisted corridors. You have an 18 floor climb.
Wow.
with three bosses, every six floors there is a boss. But I could only get to the 12th floor because the apparently hardest boss in the entire set of Torghast bosses, I couldn't get past because he has a mechanic that somehow makes him take less damage. So you have to like get him down fairly fast. And I'm not well enough geared to do that. But the good thing is that, and this is like why I'm talking about this off the top of the show, is because if you want to do the, what's it called? The something lion, referring to Anduin.
Mm-hmm.
You have to find three items, quest items, and they are all drops from these three bosses in floor 6, 12, and 18. But if you can't get past the floor 12 and floor 18 boss, it's not as bad as you might think. Just leave Torghast, the tower, and re-queue and go up to floor 6 and on the new run, on the new climb.
So you can select your floor when you come back?
No.
Oh.
When you start always at floor 1. But with this quest, you would assume that, as I said, if there are quest items to be had, you need to go to the three bosses in the place to get the three items, correct?
Okay. That makes sense.
Yeah. And as I said, this is not how it works with this, apparently, because as long as you can defeat the first boss on the sixth floor, you can do that three times over.
Oh.
You don't have to run up to floor 18 and kill the 18th floor boss to get the third quest item. You can do the sixth floor boss three times, and you still get the three different quest items, which really doesn't make sense.
No. I'm confused. Yeah.
Yeah, but that's how it works, apparently. So, and I've read up on it on Wowhead, and the people that comment there are still not sure whether it's a bug or a feature. But so far, no one has heard anything
differently
than it's a feature. So if you have issues with either the 12th floor or 18th floor boss, just leave. Just click on leave Torcast, and then you get popped out of the wing and put in front of the respective wing portal to go into it.
Mm.
And then you just start at the first floor again, run up to the sixth and kill that one more time. If you finished the 12th floor boss, you only have to do the sixth floor one once to get the third item. If you couldn't, like me, get past the 12th floor one, you just go into the sixth floor and then take a shot at the 12th floor one again to get number two and three. So it's a little, illogical.
Right.
But it's still how it works, how you can get your quest items. So, hey, Big Steve, welcome.
Big Steve, hi.
Hey, how are you doing?
Yeah. Wow, good to see you in the chat room.
Very nice. That's something that I just wanted to mention for the people that now that quest is available.
Right.
To unlock the twist in corridors, twisted corridors, you can cheese your way through it, or whatever terminology you want to use.
Mm.
I didn't see that much of a difficulty increase. It was just. I could easily have defeated. I would imagine climbed the other floors, but just that one boss that was probably the boss I couldn't defeat.
Right.
In the place. So, it's been about 6 years since my last visit, so I guess this is Alcoholics Anonymous. Yeah, well, pretty much. It pretty much is.
But I know. Welcome back.
Welcome back indeed, yeah. So
welcome back to the same old place that you knew before. Sorry, couldn't resist.
No, it's no problem. It's nice to see you here.
Yeah, it is.
Steve, it is. It really is. Yeah, so, but I think that's basically what's going on. We had an interview last week.
How did that go?
With some of the devs. Not we as me, but I think it was Warcraft Radio. I think they had a PvP related interview, which is Warcraft Radio had an interview with Chris Kalicki. That's probably his name. About PvP, so that's about Ashran and stuff like that. So that's more he was a former, he might have been like he might be a former employee of Blizzard. I'm not sure. But again, I'm not the big PvP guy, so I wouldn't really know about the staff that deals with it. And I'm really looking forward to all the new content that we get now very soon. I saw my queen again in two new cutscenes. Not going to spoil anything for the people that want to experience it themselves. But let me just say that what Blizzard has done with the in-game cutscenes, the progression that the progress that they've made in making the facial expressions much more coordinated, the mouth and the jaw correspond with the voice, with the language that the characters speak, is awesome.
Yes.
It's absolutely awesome. Remember like two expansions ago, like Legion, when they really started those in-game cutscenes,
right,
where you had your character walking along,
the
NPCs, and then you still had those, you could almost say, random jaw movement that was supposed to simulate speech. Now you can almost see what they say. You can almost lip read now. Not quite, obviously, but it's like really, really close. And obviously I'm biased towards my queen, so it's absolutely awesome. And let me say, I do not know the name of the voice actor that does the Jailer's voice, but Josh Keaton, the actor that does Anduin's voice, and obviously Patty,
right,
are like awesome. The voice acting in certain scenes, the emotional involvement, the emotional depth of it all. I would assume that it's pretty much you flip a switch and they know what the other one feels and how it's supposed to be, because they've done so many scenes by now over the years.
Right.
But it's still always surprise as to how well it's working. And when I remember back to what Patty and I talked about in the interviews that we did, it's like so much different when you can be in the room together. I mean, obviously this couldn't have happened, but they might have been in a on a call together and talked about it before, together with Steve Denusa and Andrea Torres, the people that are with them in the booth, if they are like in Irvine. So it's really, I mean, I've always been a fan of voice acting,
right?
But this is like absolutely awesome. So I just wanted to mention that Construx is back. So now we can.
Who is Altraz?
Altraz.
Who is what?
Who is Ostraz? Who is this crazy person named Ostraz? Is that you, Construx?
No, it's not me.
Who is it?
I don't know. It's somebody in Clan of Darkness.
No. Wow. They just sent me a whole slew of pets.
Yeah.
What?
Oh, is that you? Is that you, Ostraz? Lost Cause? Oh, my God. Thank you. I'll have to put it in the show notes, but there were so many. All right. Thank you. You're the best. All right. What else do we have before we...
I don't think there is much more to talk about. Let me just see if I can see something else that we need to talk about. That's general. No. Oh yeah, one more thing that I with regard to Torghast.
Okay.
And the twisting corridors. The twisting corridors are generally the place where you go to get loot other than trash and soul ash and phantasma. But today I got a pet from the regular tower.
Nice.
I didn't even know that existed, that there was like real loot in the normal wings of Torghast.
Right.
So I got a pet there, and that was really, really cool. Can't remember which one it was. I'm logging in to see if I can get it to show before.
Meanwhile, shout out to Lost Cause. Yeah, this is this was on April, because April I hadn't had her running in, because you know you gotta pay this thing called subscription. So, I finally got her up and running, and she looked in her mailbox, and there were all these awesome pets. I mean, awesome pets.
Nice.
Wow.
All right. So what are you looking up?
I'm looking for one of the pets that is available in Torghast. And
now I have the pet battle.
You have to pet battle, or to get them to max level.
Yes.
Yeah,
sure. How many did you get?
I got 8, 9. Ooh. Let me see.
Whoa.
A whole bunch. Let me see. Let me just check.
Whoa.
I got. I had to make room. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I got 13. Oh my God, you're so awesome.
Wow. Oh, he says he sent some to April too.
This is April because she hadn't been on because, okay, you know, I didn't.
Yeah,
I didn't have the money.
He said he's been getting rid of a bunch of extras because it's hard for him to manage 1,150 or so. Yeah.
But some of these are just so awesome. A wayward spirit, a bone biter. Thank you. Thank you, Lost Cause. You are amazing.
Very nice. Yeah, the one that I got was a Torghast lurker.
Ah.
It's one of the... If you remember, you go through the maw, and there are those shades.
Right.
Right.
Like the and ones that used to follow you around with the haunted memento.
Yeah. More like the ones that you have to try to not kill them, but when they're down to 50%, you siphon.
Right, you siphon the energy.
Energy from them, right. Something like that. But they just have some spikes on their shoulders. I didn't really look at them if that's like how they look, but they're like similar to that, like so, like shady, shadowy. What if you look in your pet journal? You can
see them, which is nice.
Look at the Torghast lurker. And again, I didn't know that we had normal loot, quote unquote, in the regular wings. So yeah, that was a real surprise when I got that.
Nice.
It's a green pet, so I had to use a stone, but that's okay.
That's what the stones are there for.
Yep. Oh yeah. But now I have a whole bunch of them because thankfully there are quite a few world quests that give stones as rewards.
Yeah. Yeah. And if you repeat the quests, you double your reward.
Yeah, exactly. So
nice.
If you have basically a day, maybe it's between 18 and 24 hours to get all your tunes that are eligible for the world quests to do them. And especially since you can do the world quests with your Threats of Fate tunes now. Mm-hmm. So they don't have to be max level anymore to do the world quests.
Right.
And that opens up so many opportunities. You can basically, as soon as you go on your alts, as soon as your first character is at max level and has chosen a covenant, all your alts, if they choose Threats of Fate for to level, you can immediately access all the world quests and thereby access the rewards, aka the stones, if you do the pet battles.
It's so a win-win situation.
Really, yeah. It's really good. Mm. Okay. So what does Lost Cause say? I don't mind pets that are dropped from normal mobs being green, but stuff from dungeons, elites.
They should be blue.
You purchase with tokens should be rare.
Yeah.
I do not know because it's a balance between the how rare the stone world quests are.
Mm-hmm.
If you think back to Legion and BFA, we had way fewer world quests with blue stones.
Mm.
And now
we have,
as I said, I'm at 7 or 8 tunes through the wall now. So theoretically, I can every day, and there's almost every day there is a stone quest up in some form. I can get at least every other day, I can get my 7 or 8 stones. So
like
there
I'm
are
slacking.
Like almost too many now. So, and if you consider that, if you take that into account, there is no reason why you shouldn't have green pets so you can get rid of your stones because they burn holes in your bags after a while.
Yeah.
And none of them are family specific anymore.
Oh, that's interesting.
Right. Yeah, the only family specific ones are the level stones.
Mm. Right.
That you also get from the world quest, obviously.
Right.
But the stones that you get to make a pet rare, to upgrade a pet, they're all flawless battle stones now.
Mm.
It would be an idea, because I'm going to shut up, because I don't want to give Blizzard any ideas. So,
right. Yes. Thank you.
All right. That's been it so far.
All right. Let's get going.
I've had a fantastic weekend. Wow. It's very comforting. Those battlegrounds where you're not necessarily putting out more damage, but you feel like you're contributing more by pushing all the buttons all at once. Bad boy. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you?
Constructs, how's your weekend WoW been?
My weekend WoW has been fantastic. I was really busy last week, and this week I kind of fell off the bandwagon. I was really tired, so I didn't play for 4 days.
What?
But those 4 days, I recouped quite a bit because
I
needed a couple days off.
Yeah.
So, right now I'm upgrading my heirloom legs, shoulder, and chest because they're not proccing the 2 out of 4.
Oh.
So the...
And where are you upgrading them at?
At the Ironforge. So basically, my shoulders are still low level. They're still level 1.
Right.
And I guess I never noticed that I outgrew after we got the nerf. I outgrew what level they were at.
Right. And so I would...
Basically, they're not proccing the new rested XP thing that you need to have 6 out of 7 to proc. So, I want my proc. I want my leveling because I leveled the Warlock and the Warlock got lots of stuff. I just don't have a lot of male gear. And
do you have female gear?
Have female gear.
Sorry. That was not funny at all. Sorry. I apologize.
Anyway, so my vestments are upgraded. The Regalia of Fabled Adventures is now 7 out of 7.
Mm.
And it'll scale up to 39. And nice. Since I'm 35, I got 4 more levels before I drop another 8,000 gold on that. Mm. But now I've only got 4,000 gold. I have agility gear, male gear, but I don't have intellect male gear.
Right. Which you need for hunters? No. What do you need intellect for?
Intellect male gear for shaman.
Oh, shaman. Ooh.
So now when you ding a level, you get 2 minutes of plus 40% intellect on your warlock. So it's like all of a sudden you're like super powerful and you blow stuff up.
If and, you have stuff to fight in those 2 minutes. Yes.
I triple boxed. I did a little experiment. I triple boxed an incursion. I had a level 50 mage. Wow. I had a level 60 rogue. And I had a level 37 warlock. So my warlock would ding every 3 or 4 quests. And my mage, the XP bar didn't move. I got like 900 XP per quest, which was like nothing. So you can't level doing incursions. It's going to take you a really, really long time if you're level 50. Mm. But my rogue got the 7th Legion medals because I'm trying to get to farm for that last mount. I need 350 medals. I'm at 320. And I'm just grinding as much as I can on that. So basically, when I want to level my warlock, I just go do the incursion. And at level 37, you can go to Borealis to do some questing there, which is cool. And with the Taste of Victory or the Dark Moon Wee buff, I leveled from 37 to 44 and really fast. And it, I stayed in rested XP because when you have the regalia updated, the heirloom gear, it slows down the grinding of mobs into the rested by 30%. So if your rogue is killing stuff for you, that means your rogue doesn't grind as much rested XP as if you were killing him yourself. So I went to Pandaria, did a couple of things, and my level just kept going and going and going on the warlock. I was really happy with that because I'd like to get her to max level so I can do summoning on my alliance character when I want to do something. The only thing I'm not happy is the Shadowlands price hasn't dropped yet. So if I want to gift it to myself, I have to pay full price, right, even though it's my third sub.
Right. That sucks.
So I'm like, eh, not ready to drop 54 Canadian on that. So right now I'm at level 44, so I got 6 more levels to grind, and then I'll be max level. And then I'll get the itch, and I kind of have a feeling that Blizzard's going to win that one, and I don't think you're going to drop it by 30%. I accidentally, or on purpose, didn't level jewel crafting for Shadowlands jewel crafting because I wanted to get my cult here in Master of All. So basically, it's a professions achievement, which you level every single profession to max. And the jewel crafting side of it, I had at 146, which I need to level to 185 to have to be at max level. But I got to 151 and I got the achievement out of it. So I don't have to level it. So because they did it in Culturas, they did that thing where the Zandalari, they added an extra 25 points during one of the patches to level up. But you don't need it to be at max level. So that was really nice. I kind of got the achievement as a footnote. But then I leveled a couple other professions, like engineering to Shadowlands, so I could get a few extra points in there. And it's not too bad to level. Like the porous stone is dirt cheap right now, so you can buy some for a couple silver and like level to 40 with little effort. Little effort and very little money if you have the Dark Moon Fair rebuff.
Right.
And the profession quests.
Right.
And I'm adventuring also in Pandaria, because my warlock can now farm Ghost Iron. I tried to go to the Shrine of Eternal Blossoms, the Shrine of the however many stars or whatever, and
7 stars, 2 more.
7 stars.
Right.
And then the trainer wasn't there. The trainer was in the quarry in Pandaria Forest, but there's also one in Padon Village, which I didn't know. So I had to circle back around to my other guy to figure that out. It wasn't too complicated to get the XP because he's both a miner and
herbalist.
So yes. I get double XP.
Right.
And 1,500 XP for mining one piece of rock is really great.
It is.
You get 6,000 XP per quest in Pandaria. Promi said, like, go there. I flew into Stormwind Keep. She gave me the quest. Rel met me. I saw King Varian. He was still alive. He wasn't blown up or green or anything. So that was cool. It was cool to see that old cinematic. And I got to go to Pandaria and fly through the clouds. And it's cool to reminisce about that questing experience, how it all started. And at first I wasn't flying at all because I wanted to see on the ground what it looked like back in the day. And then eventually I was like, well, I can fly anyway. So I was just like skip and hop to the items that I wanted. And when you fight Hosen, I was scared I was going to get that I was going to wipe, because in the Jade Forest, what happens is when you pull a Hosen, sometimes you pull a whole pack of Hosens, and you're left fighting four or five of them. And right. if you don't know your button, but Affliction Warlock is super easy. You have life tap, you have Siphon Life, and you have Health Funnel. So between you and your pet, you can basically crowd control stuff. And I like to have the succubus follow me around, because she's really good. She does good damage and stuff. And I was
oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
So you're not a blueberry?
No, it's not the Voidwalker. I care for the Voidwalker, except on my human warlock.
Ooh.
She has the Voidwalker, but most of the time I get the Felguard out as well. I'm more of a Fel Hunter, Succubus, and Felguard type of warlock. And I think everyone has a warlock, because warlock cookies are cool.
Right? Well, you know. Mm-hmm. At one point, they were OP'd.
Yes. At one point, they were just super awesome. Just
and you needed
warlock to every raid.
Right. And, yeah, because you could
summon.
Yeah, you could summon. And that was a big thing back in the day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know if it ever took five people to summon, but, like, three people is good, because that's the number of accounts I have. I don't ever want to go back up to five.
Right, right.
Like, three is good, and I'm finding that I have an easy time doing the test your strengths. I turn it in on six different characters this time around, because I just do it the whole month long, and then
right
when the next Dark Moon Fair comes around, I have all these characters that have cleared all these mobs one at a time, you know, while I'm watching a movie or whatever. And that's a little bit of what I was doing on my main and alts. I was alternating which character was doing quests so I could have all my cooldowns up and doing a whole lot of damage. And when I was doing incursion, my rogue was doing the bulk of the killing, because that way I could just keep plowing through the mobs in Morales, or the ones in Nazmir, or the ones in which other... I did three incursions. I did Nazmir, I did Morales, or Thrissguard Sound,
right.
And I did the desert place. I forget what it's called. Buldoon, yeah. So basically, my buff would carry over, and when I would run out of buff, I would just log out, whatnot, so I could have my buff for the following time I logged in, the full hour, and then that way I continued to have a rolling fast questing experience, so to speak. I think Blizzard wants us to get the max level so we buy more stuff off them. It's just how it is. It's not.
You think they have a plan?
I think they know what they're doing. I think this friendly, easygoing type of, you know, gather a few mounts, do a few quests. Little thing. I think in the end, they all want us like the blue elves, you know, high on mana crack. And I'm enjoying the auction house a little bit. Oh, that's what I did. As I sold, I was watching the price of the volatiles, and I sold four volatile waters for 225 gold each, which is insane. Wow. Somebody was crazy enough to jack the price. I thought, that's way too high to buy, but it's a good price to sell.
Right, right.
So when it's down at 30 gold, I buy it. And when it's up at 225 gold, I sell it. It's just like, why break my back, you know, gathering stuff when I could just watch the prices on the auction house? And Trade Skill Master makes it easy because it does like a one-click thing where you sell five of them at a time. Mm-hmm. So you don't have to the hair looking the item up on the other screen. Is it a good time to sell? Is it a good time to buy? It's like it puts all the information in one window for you to decide whether or not it's a good price. And if there's none on the auction house, it won't have a listing. It'll just have a suggested price according to the Undermine Journal or whatnot. So it'll already give you an inflated price that you could list to gouge. So I'm like, okay, just one button push.
Right.
So every two or three days, I go check out all my auctions and I relist what didn't sell. And I'm at 810,000 gold, which is not too bad on my main. I have more gold than that, but it's spread out throughout my accounts. So I don't really know where all my gold is. I just know I have it.
Right. And, isn't there an app? Isn't there a add-on for that?
Alcoholic, but yeah. they put out a disclaimer that is no longer
accurate.
Available on Twitch. You have to go to CurseForge. So they're not supporting Twitch updates anymore. And it's on there on the update button when you try to update it or whatnot.
Oh man!
So it refuses the Twitch thing. I have high hopes of getting my 1200 ghost iron ore from Pandaria, because now I can just take three characters there and then just do questing and then level up that way by way of having multiple characters follow the same quest line.
Right.
So basically you're getting tons of XP, you're getting ore, you have an enchanter, you can disenchant on the spot.
Oh, yeah, right.
You have two miners, you can mine on the spot twice. So
and I'm both like, of you get XP.
I could do it the hard way and just try and farm it all at half hill, but it's going to take a really long time. If I just fly around Jade Forest, there's nobody there. Like, it's hard to find somebody in Jade Forest right now. A lot of people are farming different spots or trying different ways to level, or they're just all moved into Shadowlands and they don't go back. But so far, I've been very fortunate in my adventures. I've not run out of stuff to do. I just, real life hits real hard. This week I was sick on Friday and I was like, I can't go to work. And my employer was like very very good at understanding, and Monday I wasn't feeling well either, so I'm really grateful that I have a job that gives me sick days, because otherwise I would have to go to work sick.
And that's not good.
No, you know,
that's a problem. Yeah, that's a problem we're having right now, because people are going to work sick and spreading. Yeah.
That is not something I want to do. Like, if I'm sick, I don't want to make my coworkers sick. So my employer is really good. You know, they're like, if you're sick, just stay home. You know, like, you're very understanding, and like, I'm immensely grateful. I still get paid for the day, so it's not every business that's like that. But I think we're fortunate where we live in Canada. That
you live in Canada?
The boss doesn't come to check on you, see what you're doing. It's just like, they take your word for it. So I I'm thinking that my rep with the other factions and in Shadowlands has to get to Revere to unlock that flying achievement. Mm. And I have 51 out of 100 world quests done, the different world quest achievements. So I'm thinking I need that as well. And there was a couple of Pathfinder achievements. I can't remember where they all are. I think I'm going to go back to the Pathfinder Part 1 and Part 2 to see what they were. That way I'll have as much of the achievement when flying comes in. Because I don't know what they're going to give us flying. I kind of...
9.1. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I kind of get the feeling that once flying is unlocked, it'll be mayhem in the new zones. Because then you'll be able to farm all the materials from the air.
Mm.
And as it is, some of those materials are easy to farm because you don't have to land. You can just pluck them without pulling. So that's kind of what I'm looking for, is the easy farm. And with three accounts, yes, you don't have the multi-box option anymore to push the buttons to the different accounts. But you can still multi-box by switching screens. And
you know, that's the way I have always multi-boxed. I've never used the push thing. I've always alt-tabbed.
Well, I used the push thing because Jeffy recommended it, and it did make a big difference when you were fighting something big.
Right, right.
But if you are fighting normal mobs, not elites, then it's quite all right to just alt-tab or switch between your different screens and have a computer that's good enough to accommodate that, so that's awesome for me. I'm fortunate. I bought it when I had money. Now there's no money, so we have to do what we have with what we can.
Mm.
I don't know what's going to happen with all my professions. I kind of want to get the Legion one done, but that means I have to go back and do all the questing, because a lot of stuff is like buried in dungeons or have to do with rep.
Right.
So I don't know if I'll have time or whatnot. I found that the Dark Moon quests are nerfs if you're at max level. If you're at max level or at 50 and above, the Dark Moon quests are only worth 900 XP.
I noticed that. And I thought,
but if you're at low level,
then it's still good. Yes,
3,000 to 6,000. Yeah,
right.
So that doesn't make me happy. That frustrates me.
Right, because Org.
I use that to level.
Yeah, me too. Org is at 44, and she's getting 7,200 for the Dark Moon Fair quest. So
yeah,
yeah.
And when you do when you do a pet battle at Dark Moon Fair, you get more XP for the pet battle than you do for the quest turn in, which is kind of weird.
Yes.
It's backwards.
Yes.
But do I have my pets on here? No, I have to log off. Okay, so I'm still doing Dark Moon Fair because that is still relevant, but I don't know how I'm going to level all my different quests in Shadowlands, because you have to get all your alts through them all. So other than multi-boxing them all, because I did it with Grand Negus a couple of times,
right?
The multi-box is super fast because you fill out the bar twice as fast. Just like when you do an incursion, your low-level character gets the XP without having to kill everything. So you could put a dot or whatnot on it, and that's good enough to get the XP.
If you want it, you should put a dot on it. If you want it, you should put a dot on it. Oh, sorry. It was funnier in my head. like a moan.
Why would I do that?
I'm still trying to build more sky golems and whatnot, but I have like 22 miles in the sands.
Oh, no.
Yeah. No, not 22. I have over 30 vials of the same. They're not selling.
Oh, my gosh.
I think it's because I'm not undercutting enough. I'm charging too much for them.
Wow, you don't want to bring down the price.
Wait for flying to hit again.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping.
I think that once we get flying in Shadowlands unlocked, that's going to...
change everything, yeah.
Not everything, but that might give some people
motivation.
Opportunity, let's put it that way, to find the reason why they want to buy a mount.
Yeah. Anyway, I'm doing my pet battle for the Feasals right now. And rematch already selects the when you click on it, it selects your team for you.
Mm-hmm. Oh right, rematch.
Yeah, so that's really cool. That's well done. I wish I'd thought of it, but somebody else thought of it first. So that's been my week, and. I'm just really, really having fun at Dark Moon Fair, and I think it's going to be many, many more years of Dark Moon Fair for me, because I don't think I can ever give up professions. I have too much invested.
Right. All right.
And that's been the week.
Good week. Many alts. My dog is trying to poop for the horn. And for the alliance! It was funnier in my head.
Brilliant. How was your week in WoW?
My week in WoW has been very productive. I think I used Darkmoon Fair to my main advantage. But before I get into my week in WoW, I want to give another shout out to Lost Cause. Darkshore Sentinel. Echoing Ooslin. Fragment of Anger, Poda, Pora, Baby Stonehide, Chronomus, Cobalt Raven, Coral Lashing, and a Crimson Bat Pup. Oh my God, these are so cool. And I especially like the Poda because I had a cousin passed away a few years ago, and his nickname was Pooda, and I'm going to rename this guy Pooda in honor of him. So thank you, Lost Cause, for all the pets you sent me, and I will give them a good home. That's what he said. He hoped I could give them a good home, and yes, indeed, I will, 100%. All right, so when last we met me, last week, I was doing the Maw, and that went really well. I actually finished it, and Aprilian ended up in Oribos. Thank you. And I have to say, I enjoyed that quest line a lot. I enjoyed hanging out with Thrall again and Jenna. Proudmore?
Jaina.
I'm sorry, Jaina. You say Jaina, I say Jenna. Let's call the whole thing off. I re-upped three of my...
Did they call the whole thing off?
No, they're still going. So right now I'm
Are you sure?
Are you sure? I am I am knee deep in Moon Fair. I had plans for tomorrow that got canceled, but that's why we're doing the podcast today. But hey, you know, this was nice because, you know, we got to get together before Dark Moon Fair ended. I had Auric a couple of weeks ago, running around and doing pet battles and digging and getting a lot of XP. And so, but then the subscription ran out, and now she's back, and she's level 44, and I hope to get her by the end of this week because, you know, I'm on vacation, so I should be leveling a lot. I'm hoping to get her to 50 at least, if not 60. But I guess what I should be doing is working on getting Aprilian and April to 60. Aprilian is at 51 and 2.5 bars. April is in the mall getting ready to hang out with Thrall and Jaina at 50 and 2/3. So I'm looking forward to doing that quest again because it was fun. And now that I know what I'm doing, I mean, I know some people think, oh my God, you're doing the same quest again. But when you go back in with a different tune, especially a different kind of tune, because April is a death knight, so I have better hopes for her than I did for Aprilian. Even though Aprilian did okay, but now that I know the quest and know what we're doing, it's even better. What else am I doing? I'm also leveling up a couple of my other tunes. And I'm going to go on my Iron Man tune later on. There was something you said that I wanted to elaborate on, but I forgot what it was. Oh, Dark Moon Fair. Oh, one time I had April and Auric in Dark Moon Fair. And they were out of sync. And they were both, I didn't understand that, because they were both in, what's the thing?
The mall.
They're both in war mode. So I didn't understand why they were in Dark Moon Fair but out of sync. I don't know what that meant. But
I had that happen when I teleported to Dalaran. Mm-hmm. All of a sudden the two characters weren't in sync anymore.
But then we went to Dark Moon Fair and we're both on the other side of the gate and we can't see each other. I mean, I do that specifically so that I don't have to run one tune down that hill. And I had to...
Did you group and ungroup and regroup?
No, I didn't. Because then April went off to the mall. Mm-hmm. And Auric is just doing all the quests in Dark Moon Fair. So I just gave up. Anyways, I did buy a couple of hats. I hope I don't regret that for April. She's at 41 minutes with the buff.
Right.
And hopefully before the night's out, she'll be able to play some more. And she's off. Going to reach the upper Tremeculum. And in the meantime, Aprilian is getting ready to go to Dark Moon Fair. And I'm also then, I got so much to do now. Level some of these pets. Because they were level one, and I can't stand level one blue pets. I think they just all deserve. Maybe I'll sit around in Ogrimmar and pet battle. That might be fun. And, I just got an achievement. That's a lot of pet food. So that's, and then that means I got another pet. Thank you, Lost Cause. So that's a lot of pet. Collect 400 unique pets and you get Venus. So Venus has been added to my pet collection. because of Lost Cause. So thank you. I really appreciate that. And I'm going to... No, grats to you. Lost Cause just said grats, and I'm like, no, grats to you. You're the one that deserves the grats. You did that. And that's been my week. I'm just running through the mall right now with Thrall and Jaina. And I managed to reactivate some accounts, so I'll be able to play more. And we'll
Steve in the chat room says the upper trabeculum sounds like part of the digestive system.
Yes, yeah, it does. All right, that's been my week.
And Lost Cause says you're quite welcome.
Thank you. I'm a lucky person.
I find it very, very easy to be true.
I'm on a schönst in Forest of Suhaus. Und ob sonst mich einst in die Welt hinaus. Und in der Ferne suchte ich mein Glück. Wer kennt den Weg?
And now it's time for Add-on Spotlight and a whole bunch of other things with Grand Negus. Grand Negus, what do you have for us this week?
I put a couple of pictures in the screenshots, parts of screenshots in the show notes. The first one is of the pet that I mentioned that I got from Torghast. So you can see him. I assume it's a him. in all his glory, the half torso that he is with long arms. I'm not sure. It's like yeah. Anyway, So, and the second one is about the first topic that I want to talk about. It's the crafting of legendaries in Shadowlands, where I crafted my first legendary for Trelane, for my Forsaken Warlock.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. The crafting itself is the process is you initially go into Torghast, and then you find the rune carver, which is the guy that does the crafting for you, the rune carving. And he gives you a couple of quests. Basically, he tells you that I completely lost my memory. I got, like, basically amnesia. So then he tells you, could you please find my memories? And you go out and find basically the legendary memories that you find for him are the recipes for the respective abilities that you want to use in your legendaries. So say you want, as with my legendary, it's basically a ability that lets my corruption have a slow effect. And something else, I think 15% more damage or something like that. And that memory you find wherever you find your respective memories that you need for your respective legendaries. And then you go back to the room cover in his area of Torghast and teach him those lost memories again. So he remembers them. And then you can, after you bring him some currency, in this case, soul ash, which you get from climbing the Torghast Tower and defeating the final bosses of the regular wings in various layers of difficulty. Then you go and craft those legendaries from with additional items. If you look at the on the screenshot, you can see in the left on the left side there is this purplish skull type icon that represents my legendary memory for the ability, and then in the middle is a pair of pants. That's because the legendary ability is supposed to be on my pants. Then you have the 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock slots where you put your missives, I think they're called, which are basically your predetermined secondary stats. So you want to have, in my case, mastery and haste. So I put a mastery missive and a haste missive in those two slots. And then I hit create, and then he crafts, the room cover does, my Sakulash's dark strikers, the pants that you can see the legendary item pop up. And since it's my first, I got the legendary accord, which is the achievement for the first legendary. Yeah, that's basically. And then the base item level of my pants is 190. If, and that costs me 1250 soul ash, if I remember correctly. If you waited long enough, you can skip the first level, the 190 item level, and go to higher item level legendaries to basically craft the higher item level legendary outright, because you do not need to craft stage 1 to do stage 2, to do stage 3, and so forth. You can craft whichever you can afford, so to speak. The main issue you are going to have, especially in the early days of the expansion, is that you probably won't have enough soul ash, even if you have the other or all the components that you need, all four components, you probably won't have enough soul ash. I already bought my level 3 pants token because probably tomorrow I'm going to craft my level 3 item level 225, I think. No, that's 235, something like that, 210 190 to 10 to 25, something like that, are the steps that, and the higher the item level, the more expensive, obviously, the items are. So if you can, if you have enough soul ash, you can outright either craft yourself the token that you need for your respective slot, or you can go and buy it on the auction house. And then basically imbue that empty slot, as I talked about last week, with the memory and the two missives and the soul ash.
Right.
So, yeah. The only thing that you need to be aware of is that you need the soul ash regardless of what level of item you buy, crafted item to buy, double check, go to the internet, to probably Wowhead, and check how much soul ash you need for the item, for the level that you want to create, because nothing is more irritating
than not having enough soul ash.
Yeah, than not having enough soul ash
or using the wrong amount.
Yeah. Especially if, let's say, you go and buy one of the items, and then you calculate it wrongly.
Right.
And then you have to wait another week because you climb.
Because you reach your limit of soul ash.
Yeah, you did your run for the week already. You don't have, you can't get any more soul ash. Especially since the only alternate
source,
soul ash source, is a is either the Torghast quest chain to unlock the Twisting Corridor that I talked about earlier, or your mission table. There are.
Is soul ash at your mission table?
Yes, but the mission table is not the same as we had in Legion or in BFA. It's quite a lot harder. And you can obviously...
run out of soul ash.
No, you can wing it.
Okay.
And use all your anima to power the elite missions.
Right, but is that a good source of good use for your soul ash?
No, it's not a use for. No, you don't need soul ash for the missions.
Oh.
It's just the chance of if you haven't kept your mission table followers that run the missions at maximum, it's not very likely that they're going to succeed.
Right.
And so is it worth it? If you need 100 soul ash and you get 150 out of the mission, you might as well try it, but right. It's not very likely that they're going to make it, to succeed on the mission. And having that chance being the only potential source for the soul ash that you so desperately need isn't a good place to be, in my opinion. And then imagine you paid, say, 100,000 for the item on the auction house, and then you have to wait for a week. Or for, say, 3 or 4 days, And when it flips over and you can do your runs again, the amount of gold you have to pay, the price is down to 50,000.
Right, so you could have saved that.
So you basically threw away 50,000 gold just for buying it way too early.
Right.
When you couldn't even use it yet. So that's... There's always... There are quite a few calculations that you need to make before...
You buy soul ash.
Before you buy the item. Soul ash, again, you have to either get from quests, get from the climb, or get from your mission table. You cannot buy soul ash.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
So it's the item.
It's the new soulbound crawl.
Right.
It's what?
It's the new soulbound.
Soulbound crawl.
Yeah, yeah.
Basically.
Basically. So I think you get 600 and change from any of the two wings that you can run. So that's like 1,200, something like that, per week as a maximum, I think. And then once you're done with the twisting corridors, you don't get any more there because you're done with the quest, so there's nothing more coming there. And then there's only the third and final source, and that's the potential mission table. But I'm sure you have to, or I'm not sure, I would assume that you need to have your mission table at a certain stage of upgrade to get the mission table missions for Soul Ash, I think. But again, that's all. That's me guessing. I don't know because all my mission tables are only level one because those are. That's a thing that I'm going to save for last to upgrade in my sanctuary.
Can I interrupt for 1 second?
Sure.
So I'm in the Temeculum and I'm at those spikes.
Yeah.
And I can't help but hear Sigourney Weaver go, "Who designed this? What is this here for?" But I guess this is to make us walk straight. But anyways, go ahead.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so speaking of the maw, the latest tune I ran through the maw was my Pandaren Hunter, but I have a picture of my gnome rogue. In the show notes, where if you go take a screenshot of your character just after you plummet into the maw, they have that aura around them that.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah. I really like that. It's like a cool visual effect.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and that's basically what I've got for this week.
Okay.
Let me just see if there's anything that I've got. Yeah, one achievement that I didn't mention was Working the Afterlife.
Yeah, Working the Afterlife. I got that too.
Yeah.
Nice.
Congratulations.
Again, Blizzard and their naming.
Yes.
It's just cool. Obtain maximum skill points in a Shadowlands category of two primary professions.
Yeah.
So, and that's been my week.
Awesome.
Good week.
Yes. Very good week. All right. Let's, now's the time I get to play this.
We're Clan of Darkness here together. What's in an egg that we can't weather? Apocalypse. We've all been there. The same old boss. Why should we care?
We're Clan of Darkness here together. What's in an egg that we can't weather? There's nothing that we can't face.
Constructs, how have the Clans of Darknesses on Earthen Ring and Control Alt WoW on Nevekuf and Wormrest Accord been doing this week?
It looks like Earthen Ring and Winterhoof had the bulk of the leveling this week.
Okay.
I saw Matarosa on and getting level 45. Good job, Mata.
Good job.
And
Mata.
We also have Nincalpoop.
I love that name.
Whoever that is.
And then
you got level 50. Congratulations. To all our
level ones. All right. Yeah. All right. I just want to do a shout out to Kyle. I'm sorry that we recorded early this week because I had something to do tomorrow, but now I don't have to do it. But yeah.
It's your safety, so it's okay.
It's okay. I can't even believe how relieved I am that I don't have to go out. But we will record next Sunday, episode 693, and this is a brilliant...
Well, next Sunday would be tomorrow. We're not recording again tomorrow.
Next, the following Sunday, a week from tomorrow. A week from tomorrow. Bearing any other
unforeseen circumstances.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
This is a brilliant for the Horde and the new microphone.
This Constructs for the Auction House and the Sky Golem Sales.
And this has been Glenn Nagus, Rule of Acquisition, number 19. Satisfaction is not guaranteed. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Oh, I miss my Star Trek Deep Space Nine. I watch them all now.
Oh, aren't they good, though? Even if you
can never watch enough Star Trek Deep Space Nine.
Right. I don't know if
you can... start over.
Yes, just start over. Or what I like to do... Okay, I'm going to stop recording.